Welcome back to United Tradesman Academy. Hey guys, I got a quick, small update for you. A new code change. A job I just recently did over the weekend, a little bit of last week, and just got finished up today with a green tag inspection. So, as you may know, if you are doing a panel change or a panel upgrade, they are now requiring a emergency disconnect, service disconnect. I talked about it in my last video. Just 50 amp main breaker right there. So basically how this is wired in, how it used to be before you had to put this on, the power from the meter went straight into the panel inside the garage. Well, now you have to go from the meter down to the service disconnect, out of the service disconnect into the panel. So here, let's see what it says right here on Google. It says, based on a change that was incorporated into the NEC 2020, an emergency disconnect is now required per section 230.85. This disconnect is intended to give first responders the ability to shut down power to the entire home before entering to address the emergency. So that's why this service disconnect is put up. And also too, I mentioned it in my last video. So this is the panel we're putting in. And also too, that surge protector also too. And green tag inspection. So the inspector, we had an inspection on Friday and he failed me because I did not have this emergency disconnect right here. But I had an inspection back in July, maybe one street over, and I didn't have a service disconnect and it passed. Well, now they're actually enforcing the code here. So, or the new 2020 code they're enforcing. So now for all you guys who do these type of jobs, make sure you put your service disconnect, make sure you do all your grounding correctly, because that your existing panel that was in there, that's in the garage or that's in the home, it becomes a second means of disconnect. So it is not your first means of disconnect. So what you have to do, if you have a cold water ground, if you have a UFA ground, well, you have to extend those out to the first means of disconnect, which is this emergency disconnect here. And also too, what you must remember is that you have to use a non-reversible crimping method of extending those wires. You can't just put a split bolt or a butt splice on there and screw it down. They want it to be a non-reversible crimp. So, because they will fail you on that if it's not a non-reversible crimp. So look, hey man, thank y'all for my people that's been watching. E-Team, let's go, baby. We back at it. We got some more videos coming. So I just want to give y'all this quick update on this code, because had I known before, then I probably would have done a little bit better on this job. But sometimes that's what happens. You learn as you go, and you learn on the job. But hey, we'll see y'all next time back at United Tradesman Academy.